And welcome back, everyone, to Let's Play the DLC Case in Dual Destinies. We were in the middle of doing some investigations around the pool area, right? I think we're actually almost done, so we just need to check out one more spot. That is, if I can check out this spot. There we go. What a mess! Was all the stuff knocked over when the victim struggled with his killer? It's possible, but it would be hard to prove. Let's take a closer look, shall we? Just so this is where the body was found, huh? If they suspect Orla, maybe they found some evidence of an attack on the victim? Orla didn't attack the captain! She loved him! The captain rescued Orla when she was little, after she got beached on the shore. He tried to release her into the ocean, but she kept coming back. I can tell Orla is sad about losing the captain. She's just not her usual chipper self. Orla must really love this aquarium and the captain. She's the only one around here, big and strong enough to play with the big, tough captain. Every day, she made a point of headbutting him and stealing his hat. Yikes. I guess you weren't kidding when you said the captain was a really strong guy. I guess that's about it.
Under different circumstances, I would have loved to see the Swashbuckler Spectacular.
The three of us always perform the show together. Me, Orla, and the captain. Today's show has been canceled, but we could put on a little performance for you now.
Swashbucklers! Me Buckles! We love to sail the seven seas! We've come to rout that mangy blackguard, Dread Pirate Noishdash! Avast! There he be! Noishdash himself! Prepare to feed the fish!
Am I playing the role of Noishdash?
Well, Sasha has a stash and you don't, so I guess so.
Hit him with your water cannon, Captain, and spare no quarter! We swim through storms and waves all the way. Great treasure and adventures waiting just for me.
Oh, I thought he was. I didn't realize he was singing the song.
Wow, that was awesome. Your performance packed quite a wallop.
Yeah, I for one feel like I took quite a beating.
Sorry about that. Can't have a show without a bad guy role, right?
But a singing orca, huh? Must have been tough to train her to do that.
That's Orla's best trick! She can only sing one song, though.
Well, she's still got one up on a piano, so can't even play one song. Phoenix. Well, now that we had a taste of the show, we better do some more investigating.
Good idea! Let's go to the Aqua Tunnel!
To the Aqua Tunnel, that is. So you all done investigating the pool already? We had a good look around, but now we're moving on to other areas.
How is the police investigation going? Did you, say for example, find any other suspects besides Orla?
Ha ha ha! Wouldn't that be fortunate for you if we did? But no, I'm afraid not. And even more unfortunate for you, I'm afraid we found decisive evidence of the orca's guilt.
What?
Please tell me more, detective. But before we do that... So that's your symbol of justice, is it? Well, this is mine! Wow, he can whip out that badge pretty fast.
We can top that! Take this! Twin attorney badges!
Ah, no fair! Two against one!
No fair! Your police badge is bigger and flashier!
here. What? You dare to call me unfair? Me, the very model of justice itself?
Boss, I say we won this round. Athena, in this battle, there are no winners.
Oh no, I just made Fulbright pout. It's okay, boy. It's okay.
So what's this decisive evidence? Don't hold us out now, Detective Fulbright.
I am very sorry, but I can't share classified information with the defense. Especially not security footage that shows the moment the orca attacked the victim. Yep, I'm to personally see to it that this baby stays safe. It'll never leave my side.
Excuse me, but there's a call for you, Detective.
I'll be right there. Sorry, guys, you know how it is.
And you leave the camera. Well, he never said that he wouldn't leave its side. Now let's sneak a peek. Bah. What the? Is this supposed to be the moment Orla attacked the victim?
To the court records.
This little bit of footage doesn't prove anything.
I agree. I believe in Orla and Sasha. Let's just continue with our investigation.
Good idea. Huh? There's a sticker on this camera that says return to the pub of danger.
I guess somebody there manages the cameras? Let's check it out later.
Sorry about that. Prosecutor Blackwell called to remind me to go feed Taka. So, where were we? Oh, that's right. You two got any more questions for me?
No, we're good. Thank you for leaking all your info. Goodbye, detective.
This looks like one of those hands-on exhibits. It has a real air of danger, don't you think?
Well, the banner does say the pub of danger.
Let's see, according to the description, this room is a pub where pirates gather, explore, and interact with sea creatures. Actually feel the electricity of electric eels and feed real piranhas. Experience the terror of the seas with these dangerous experiments.
Experiments? I think they meant to say exhibitions. All of those sound less than like terror and more like torture to me.
Ahem. I thank you to keep it down, that blue boy. I'm conducting an experiment. Do not disturb me, unless you wish to be zapped with an electric eel.
My apologies, ma'am. Wow, she seems intense.
Excuse me, but who are you?
Before you ask others, should you give your name first? Basic manners, young lady.
Oh, yes, of course. My name is...
Never mind. I'll simply call you Yellow Girl. Easier that way. I'm Norma de Bloom. I'm very interested in Ship Shape Aquarium, and I'm a frequent visitor here.
But I don't want to be Yellow Girl.
You think I want to be called Blue Boy? Let's just see what she has to say.
I have no interest in looking at meaningless trifles. As a matter of fact, I have no interest in looking at you, Blue Boy.
What, so now I'm a meaningless trifle, too? I loved it, Plume. You guys will love her, too.
You say you're interested in the aquarium, but you don't look like a staff member. Let's see. I've got it! You're someone completely unrelated to this aquarium!
That's some deductive reasoning there, champ.
I am a visitor, a patron, a customer, a guest. And what might you be?
I'm not a what? I'm a lawyer!
Hey, that's what I was going to say. And I run a law office!
Well, whatever you are, I don't have the slightest interest.
Just who does she think she is, boss?
A visitor, a patron, a customer, a guest, remember?
I thought they closed the aquarium and weren't letting members of the public in.
Oh, but I have special permission, you see.
And why exactly is that, if I may ask?
Well, because of the heavens, I've said too much.
Oh, hey!
I remember this. Cyclocks.
Huh? Psychedelic rock? Cyber clocks? What?
No, Cyclocks. It's the power of this Magatama. It gives me the ability to see secrets locked away in somebody's heart. If I can remove the locks, I can uncover their secrets.
I didn't know you had a magical item like that.
It looks like this lady knows something about what happened. I'll just use my Magatama and undo her Cyclocks.
Huh? I can't see the locks anymore.
Huh? The color of that stone looks different from before.
That's funny. Maybe it's just out of juice?
It can do that?
Yeah. A certain girl I know poured her spiritual power into it for me. Without that power, I can't undo the Cyclocks.
No way!
Why do I have to keep quiet about it anyway? I've never been any good at keeping secrets. But I did promise, after all, so I guess I had better keep my mouth shut. Blah, blah, blah.
Who did you promise what to?
No comment! Now go away!
Just when I thought we could find out more about the case.
Let's try to find some other way. I'm sure we'll find something.
Gosh darn it, Cyclocks, Magatama, why did you stop working now?
Back to the Aqua Tunnel.
Hey, Detective Fulbright's gone. It looks like the police investigation's over.
That's too bad. I was hoping to get a little more out of him.
Yo ho ho. Cleaner? Nuh-uh, feeder. That's right. Yo, girl, why you hiding from me? I'm searching all around like this be a bad dream. Bye for yo.
Hey, whoops. Is that somebody rapping?
Rifle yo, sometimes you make me so mad. But now that you've gone, I'm just so sad. Yo, Rifle, just come back to me. We can be together and sing cree cree cree.
What's with this guy rapping and making strange bird sounds?
Yikes! Who's there?
You didn't hear me rapping, did you?
Yeah, well, maybe.
Ah! Look, just do me a favor and pretend you didn't hear nothing. Fine by us. And who might you be?
I'm Marlin Rhymes. I'm an animal keeper here.
But the aquarium is already closed today. At least, I'm pretty sure it is.
Pretty sure? You don't sound too certain. Oh, are you new here or something?
Wow, yeah, that's right. Pretty good guess. So, who are you guys?
I'm Phoenix Wright.
And I'm Athena Sykes. We're lawyers, and we're going to represent Orla. By taking her case to court and proving she's innocent.
Are you serious? You want to defend Orca in court? Oh, but if you're here for Orla, that must make you friends of Sasha's. Sorry if I came across rude.
Sounds like he's friends with Sasha.
Sometimes when I'm by myself, I like to rap to pass the time. Especially when I'm around the animals I love.
Ooh, I love animals too, especially marine creatures, like dolphins!
I like marine creatures too, but just the ones you can eat.
Yeah, well, people who like animals are good people. That's what I always say. If there's anything I can do for you too, just say the word. I just started working here too, so I don't know how much help I can be.
Mr. Rhyme seems pretty friendly.
Yeah, friendly and agreeable. We never have those kinds of people!
I'm new here, so I don't know.
I don't really think being new here has anything to do with it in this instance. Oh, you know what I haven't been presenting? The swashbuckler flyer. That gives some stuff.
With this fly, you can get a penguin sleep mask the next time you come in.
Oh yeah? That would be nice, especially if it's free.
That'd be perfect for taking a nap at the office after going for a run or something.
I prefer you didn't take naps at the office, actually.
Yeah, I feel ya. Sometimes I fall asleep when I'm feeding the animals.
I guess only a newbie can truly understand the feeling of another newbie.
Well, kindred spirits, my sister. Kindred spirits.
Two peas in a pod. Birds of a feather.
I suddenly feel so alone.
All right.
So, what exactly do you do here as an animal keeper?
Mainly, I clean the place and feed the animals. Wiping all this glass takes forever.
I don't envy your job, dude.
I can't imagine. This tunnel alone must take most of the day. I also prep the food for the animals eat. That's the hardest part of all.
You mean, it's really difficult to get the hang of?
Nah, I mean, I'm a vegetarian, so cutting fish and meat and stuff creeps me out.
Now there's something I never expected to hear from a pirate.
Do you know anything about the incident that took place this morning?
Yeah, one of our guests saw what happened and started screaming. I came running, but by the time I got there, I couldn't see the orca or the captain.
Speaking of the captain, what was he like?
Like a strong captain who can turn a wild bunch of ruffians into some great pirates. He always treated us fairly and equally, human and fishes alike. The real deal, man.
So, he's Luffy.
Hey, what are you crying for?
I'm not crying, it's just... I can feel your heart crying, that's all.
Girl, what you talking about? I'm not crying either.
I guess I won't mention that his eyes are puffier than a pair of pufferfish.
I bet Sasha and our vet, Dr. Crab, are even more upset by his death.
Vet? This aquarium has a resident vet?
Yeah. Yo, hold up. I haven't seen Dr. Crab this morning. Staff are supposed to stay put.
The night shift has been on duty since last night, but they won't let us go home. They won't let us go home. Sasha even had to get special permission to go looking for the lawyer this morning.
We haven't seen anybody who looks like a vet. Were you rapping something about looking for a weapon earlier? A rifle or something?
No, not a weapon. Rifle is the name of one of the penguins.
A penguin? Why would you name a penguin something like that?
Let me rap to ya. Ahoy! Yo! Yo-ho-ho! Prep for the battle. Prep for the war. Little Lady Rifle, gone even the score. Y'all think you can escape with your pride? Nuh-uh. You just gonna be straight up denied. Yo. Yo-ho-ho. Yo.
Wow, this is too much for me. I'm done. I'm leaving. I can't do this. Fuck this rap.
Anyway, that's what she's like. So we name her Rifle.
Okay, but did you have to wrap it?
That's just how I roll.
Oh boy.
Does Raffle wear a backpack by any chance?
Yeah, that's the one. So you've seen her, huh? She's always running away. She's such a good runner, we decided to put her to work delivering flyers.
Do you really want a dangerous penguin like that running loose?
Aw, Raffle's not dangerous. She only attacks people she doesn't like.
Only?
When we ran into her earlier, she didn't attack us. She straight up ignored us, actually.
Hey, I have an idea. If you run into Rifle again, would you mind feeding her for me? She didn't come back to the pool at feeding time like usual, so I've been looking for her. She loves the smell of fish, so she might come over to you if you have some.
Ooh, I would love to feed a penguin. That'd be okay, right, boss?
I don't mind, as long as you carry the fish.
Ew! It smells so... fishy!
Really? What a shocker.
Oh yeah, besides Rifle, I've been looking for Small Fry, too.
Small Fry? Is that another penguin?
Nah, she's a friend I made. A high school girl. She went off looking for Rifle somewhere and hasn't been back.
Is she your girlfriend?
What? Nah, no way!
Sasha is the one I...
So you like Miss Buckler, do you?
Well, I really respect her, you know? We have different tastes in music, but I admire the way she lives her life. It's not like I like her, it's more complicated than that. I'm pretty sure that all adds up to like. She tries to put on a brave face, but I think the captain's death has hidden her the hardest of all. After all, it was her human show partner that got killed by that orca.
So you think Orla really did it?
Well, I can understand how Sasha feels. But she's the only one of us who doesn't think the orca did it.
Oh, I see.
I guess it isn't easy to believe in somebody who can't even speak up for herself. Anyway, let me know if you see Rifle, Small Fry, okay? Small Fry said she was gonna go check the orca pool. Maybe we'll head back there then. Cool, thanks for sending us straight over there without me having to pick anything. Huh? There's something on the left side of the pool that wasn't there before. It looks like an electric sword?
Hey, you're back!
Hi, Sasha. What's up with this strange sword here?
Oh, that's a walkie-talkie. It's probably Rifle's. Rifle can use a walkie-talkie? She's always running away, so we attached a walkie-talkie to her. If we can hear the sounds around her, we can usually guess where she is.
But not if she drops the walkie-talkie on the floor.
Every member of the crew has one, too, so we can communicate back and forth. We even use them to broadcast to specific parts of the aquarium. Cool, huh? Well, if Rifle's walkie-talkie is here, then Rifle might still be here, too. Rifle! Come out, wherever you are! Eek! You're not Rifle!
Uh-oh.
Orla, please. Are you okay? You have to be careful around pools, or you might slip right in. I'm more afraid of my heart jumping out right now. Hey, who's that riding on Orla? Is that Rifle? Hey, you're right! Come here, Rifle!
Nope.
Ah, she ignored me again! Why does that penguin like me? Gah!
Now you've scared Rifle away with all that yelling.
Well, I'm not giving up! I'll make that penguin like me if it's the last thing I do!
Cutscene? Cutscene!
Hey! Rifle, but at least you seem all right. Oh.
Cuties!
Hey, it's Pearls?
Oh, Mr. Nick! I haven't seen you in ages.
Could Pearls be the small fry Mr. Rhymes was talking about?
Congratulations on your return to lawyering. I've been thinking about stopping by your office for a visit to congratulate you.
This is Pearl Fay. I call her Pearls. She may dress a little funny, but that's because she's a spirit medium, a real prodigy with great power at that. I've known her since she was little, and she sometimes comes to the office to visit. She's just a little older than Trucy, so she's been like a big sister to her.
I guess everyone here knows Mr. Nick, then? He's such a nice guy, don't you think?
Is she trying to be my big sister, too, now?
Oh, I'm so happy you get to be a lawyer again, Mr. Nick.
Thanks. I let our friends know I was back, too.
I wish we could all get together. It's been quite a while. Maybe we should throw you a surprise party to celebrate your comeback.
That would be really nice. But if you tell me about it, it won't be a surprise, you know?
Oh! But we could spring it! We could spring it on you after you have forgotten and still surprise you!
Cuties.
What are you doing here, Pearls?
My summer camp is here on a field trip. I've never been to such a big aquarium before, so I was really looking forward to it. But then that incident happened, and the police just finished questioning me.
Oh, I see.
Mr. Nick? Who is that lady next to you?
I'm Athena Sykes. I'm a new lawyer at the Write Anything Agency.
Oh, how do you do? My name is Pearl Faye. My cousin and my friend call me Pearly.
Pearly it is. Pearly it is, then. Nice to meet you.
So, how did the two of you meet?
She's judging.
Well, you know how I used to travel to Europe to study their legal systems, Pearls?
I met Athena on one of those trips.
So, tell me more about how the two of you met in Europe.
Hey, I thought I was supposed to be asking the questions here.
She's checking to make sure Athena's not competition now.
A long time ago, Mr. Wright helped me out of a difficult jam. That's when I started thinking about becoming a lawyer like him.
So you're like her mentor, huh, Mr. Nick?
Yeah, something like that, I guess.
Mr. Wright is the whole reason I am who I am today. So he was the one who told me my knowledge of psychology could help people in court.
Gee, Mr. Nick, it looks like you've become a real adult since the last time I saw you.
I've always been an adult the entire time I've known you, Pearls.
Well, would you look at that? Rifle loves you!
She sure does seem to be attracted to Pearls.
I'm so glad she likes me. Penguins are so adorable, aren't they? I even brought myself a little penguin calendar here at the aquarium gift shop. I have it hanging from my bag already.
Oh, it's how cute! A calendar in the shape of a penguin!
That calendar is a real hit with all our female visitors. I even have one myself. But the rest of the staff thinks it's too cutesy.
I guess it doesn't really fit the whole rough and tumble pirate image very well. But, why does this calendar smell kind of like fish?
What do you mean, Mr. Nick? Please don't be rude.
Uh-oh, I got Pearls mad. So you were looking for Rifle, too?
That's right. I was trying to help Mr. Marlin, the animal keeper.
Come here, Rifle, come on!
She went towards Orla instead.
Why can't I get Rifle to like me?
Maybe you should quit chasing after her with that scowl of yours.
Mr. Nick, how could you speak to a lady so rudely?
Uh-oh, I got Pearls mad again. Why don't you try to get Rifle to take some food from you?
Oh, great idea! And I have just the thing to offer her, too!
Where's that fish? There's that fish.
Rifle! I have a present for you! It's chocked filled with love! Here you go!
Nope!
Hey! Orla ate my love-filled fish!
At least it looks like she enjoyed it, though.
Aww.
I think Orla and I just had a bonding moment.
Friendship blossoming with the exchange of some food. Oh, isn't it moving, Mr. Nick?
I think moving might be a bit far.
Anyway, how did you get Rifle to come to you so easily, Pearls?
Anyway, how did you get Rifle to come to you so easily, Pearls?
I heard Rifle was...
I keep thinking she's gonna talk. I heard Rifle was attracted to the smell of fish.
Mr. Nick, are you saying I smell like fish?
Maybe just a little. Yes.
I guess I need to change my clothes.
That's odd. I wonder why Pearl smells like she's holding a bucket of fish.
Orla doesn't usually want to eat at this time of day.
And we've even been giving her more food than normal at her regular meal times lately. Is there something wrong with Orla's feeding habits lately?
Yeah, something's weird. The new guy, Marlin, feeds all the other animals besides Orla. But the captain and I, her trainer, are responsible for feeding Orla. It was the captain's turn to feed Orla this morning. But Orla keeps coming to me and signaling she's still hungry. She wants my fish, chock-filled with love!
How long are you going to keep saying that? She sure is excited to make a new friend.
But I don't think the captain would have forgotten to feed Orla. Rifle and that big creature here there certainly seem to love each other.
This is Orla the Orca. Rifle and Orca are best friends. They belong together like a clownfish and a sea anemone.
Care to phrase that in a way us non-biology majors can understand? Hey man, I'm not a non-biology major. And I still got it.
Oh, so this orca is the suspect. I read in a book once that orcas eat penguins.
Don't you worry about that. Orla here is really gentle, and she never eats anything but fish.
She's an old sweetheart. As a matter of fact, she even tolerates rifle picking on her.
It's true. She does seem very gentle. She hardly seems like a killer whale.
As lawyers, we have to do everything we can to save this beautiful, gentle creature. Wow, you're going to defend her in court? She's quite a defendant, isn't she?
She's the biggest defendant we've ever had. Literally. Oh goodness, it's already 31 in. I think we will stop here, and we shall continue with the rest of this in the next video. So I'll see you guys then.